Students, today we are starting with EVS 2, Chapter 8, Beginning of Settled Life, Part 1. The first point which we are going to learn today is beginning of domestication of animals and agriculture. So, domestication of animals. Domesticated animals like the dog, goat, sheep, cattle, buffalo, etc. are useful in many ways to the human being, to man. And there are three main steps in the domestication of species of any animal. So how the domestication started, this process involves three main steps. So first they used to capture the wild animal. And then they used to tame the captured animal. Tamed means to train them, to domesticate them. And they started training them to live with the human beings. And the last step is obtaining useful materials like milk, eggs, etc. from them and training them to work for the humans as a beast of burden. So the last step was to use them for their own need. So if they were cows, they used to use it for their milk. If there were some hens, they used to use it for their eggs. And slowly, slowly, they also started using them as a beast of burden, for example, in the farm, to plow the field. When the third step was achieved, the animal was supposed to be completely domesticated. So there were the three steps. First was capturing, then taming, and then obtaining useful materials. When all these three steps were achieved, the animal is supposed to be domesticated. And domesticating animals and keeping them for own use is called animal husbandry. So what is animal husbandry? Domesticating wild animals and keeping them for their own use is known as animal husbandry. As we have already seen in our sixth lesson, that the dog was domesticated in the Middle Stone Age. So the dog is the first animal that have been domesticated. Dogs were used to help with hunting. So dog was the first animal to be domesticated and they used to help human beings, the man, Stone Age man, in hunting. The goat and the sheep were domesticated next. So the first was the dog, then came the goat and the sheep. Next is agriculture. Archaeological evidence is available to show that agriculture began about 11,000 years ago. And it was first started in Israel and Iraq. And women are credited to start cultivation. Who are credited to start cultivation? Women. And they might have used the pointed sticks to store seeds. So pointed stick means, as you can see on the screen, this is the stick which has a point below. And this kind of sticks were used to sow seeds. Also, in nowadays, today also, this method is used by women in some tribes, tribal areas. In order to help digger into the soil, the stick was weighted using a perforated stone. So this is a stone tied to the stick. In order to dig deep into the soil, this stone was attached to the stick. Also, in previous lessons, that is the seventh lesson, we have learned that people had to stay in one place because of the nature of agricultural work. First, they used to hunt animal. Hunting was their major work. But slowly, slowly, as they started doing agriculture, it became necessary to stay in one place for the longer period of time. Agricultural production increased considerably after plow pulled by animals came into use. Means, they use the animals, that is the cow, bullock, calves, buffaloes, to plow the field. And so their production increased because animal came into use and agriculture became the main source of livelihoods. Also, after this, the people began to worship the nature and various deities for the good crops. So now as we worship the rain so that we get proper crops every year. So similarly, they started some tradition and culture. And essential things like sharing of agricultural tasks, water resources, and the security of village settlements gained importance. So for agriculture, they started settling in one place, and slowly, slowly, the village security of the village settlement gained importance. Also, people in the village settlement, they started establishing some rules and customs to manage their things. And thus, a social system based on agriculture came into existence. So, because of agriculture, there was a social system. They started implementing some rules. They started worshipping God. They started worshipping some other deities in the nature. And hence, the social system based on agriculture came into existence. Means it began. Next is a special skill and various occupation. So in the times before agriculture, some people obtained food such as meat, fruits and roots by hunting and gathering. But they were not able to store it for the long period of time. And therefore, all the men and women in the community were continuously engaged, were busy getting the food. But in this agricultural system, it became possible to store food grains for the long period of time. And that is why they had some time available with them. And there was more food available than needed by the community. And that is why some women and men began to get the spare time and they started experimentation. They had some natural creativity and they started developing some things. And members with such special skills were given work based on those skills. So as you can see in the picture, a woman potter, she's making handmade pots. So these were some creativity work given to some members of the community. And with this started the craft, that is the making of earthen pots, beads, making of jewelry. And it is believed that in the New Stone Age, women made earthen pots and other earthen objects. So here we come to an end of the part one. I hope you all have understood this part one.